Hello friends, this is Bindu. Today we will study about diagnosis of dental caries. I divided it into two parts. Second part I will explain you in next video. So today's topic is diagnosis of dental caries. What is diagnosis? Diagnosis is defined as utilization of scientific knowledge for identifying a disease process and to differentiate it from other disease process. In other words, determination and judgment of variation from the normal. So caries diagnosis implies deciding whether a lesion is active, progressing rapidly or slowly, or whether is already arrested. First, I will discuss about the assessment tools. An idea about the diagnosis and treatment planning depends on the assessment of patient history, clinical examination, nutritional analysis, salivary analysis, and radiographic assessment. So these assessment tools are gives an idea about the high-risk caries patient and low-risk caries patient, and also helps in diagnosis and treatment planning of the caries. There are various methods of dental caries. First method is visual and tactile method. This method is based on combination of light, mirror, and gentle probing. Visual method is most commonly used method in which teeth are cleaned and dried with compressed air and illuminated with adequate light source. It includes looking for cavitation, surface roughness, opacification, and discoloration. Problem of using this method is discolored pits and fissures, which is universally finding in normal adult teeth, may be mistaken for the caries. For tactile method, explorer and dental floss are used. Explorer are widely used for detection of caries tooth structure and also useful to remove the plaque and debris and check the surface characteristics of suspected caries lesion. When an explorer sticks, it usually a good indication that there is a decay beneath. However, when it does not stick, it does not necessarily mean that decay is not present. There are many disadvantages of explorer. That's why the use of explorer is not advocated. Those are sharp tips physically damage the small lesions with intact surfaces. Probing can cause the fracture and cavitation of the incipient lesion. It may spread the organism in the mouth. Mechanical binding may be due to non-carious lesion, for example, shape of the fissure, sharpness of explorer, force of the application, and path of the explorer placement. And it is not effective for interproximal detection of caries. For pit and fissure caries, softening is present at the base of the pit or fissures. Opacity seen surrounding the pit or fissures, and softened enamel may be flaked away by extensive explorer penetration. For non-cavitated lesion, which is smooth surface caries, there is no signs of cavitation after visual or tactile examination. The surface is matted or not glossy when tooth is dried. And it is mainly present at the gingival margin where plaque accumulates. And in the cavitated lesion, there is a visual breakdown of tooth surface present. An active cavity on the smooth surface has soft walls and floors are seen. Next, arrested caries. The arrested caries lesions are observed clinically as intact but discolored and usually black or brown in spots. The change in color may be due to trapped organic debris and metallic ions within the enamel. These discolored remineralized lesions are intact and highly resistant to subsequent caries, so the arrested caries are no need to remove. Next, recurrent caries. It is diagnosed whenever there is a softness due to caries at defective margin and when the tip of the periodontal probe can be entered the defect without any resistance. A restoration with discolored margin or a small marginal ditch is recorded as early recurrent caries area. A larger defect should be classified as advanced recurrent caries area. There are two valid indicators of recurrent caries. Softness at the margin of the filling that is detected using an explorer, or presence of the large defect or a minimum diameter of 0.4 mm at the margin of the filling and softness in the area. The large defects are associated with high level of the colonization with karyogenic bacteria. Then root caries. Root caries, for the diagnostic purpose, there may be the active root surface lesion and inactive root surface lesion. Active root surface lesion are well defined, are showing the yellowish or light brown discoloration, covered by the visible plaque and presence of softening and leathery consistency on probing with moderate pressure. And for arrested root surface lesion, well defined dark brown or black discoloration, smooth and shiny surface, and hard on probing with moderate pressure. Next method of diagnosis is advances in visual method. First is fiber optic transillumination. Fiber optic transillumination is an enhanced visual technique that uses the principle of illuminating the teeth to detect the presence of caries. The principle behind the illuminating teeth is that the demineralized areas of the enamel or dentin scatter light more than the sound area. Incipient caries appears as darker area in the resultant images, which are often during the screening. This technique is based on the fact that carious enamel has lower index of the light transmission than sound enamel. This method of caries detection uses the light source, preferably bright, to illuminate the tooth. Caries or demineralized area in dentin or enamel shows up darkened area with this technique. This effect can be achieved with a fiber optic illuminator, which is readily available at the handpiece coupler of the dental operatory and has been used for the detection of the proximal and occlusal caries. Proximal caries can be diagnosed with the light probe position on the gingiva below the cervical margin of the tooth, whereby the light passes through the tooth structure and proximal decay produce a dark shadow on the occlusal surface. Next method is digital imaging of fiber optic transillumination. It uses the same principle like fiber optic transillumination, in which the white light is delivered through the optic fiber via the handpiece and channeling the image back to the digital camera and visualize the image on the monitor via the computer system. Next method of diagnosis is endoscopy filtered fluorescence method. This method is based on the observing the fluorescence that occurs when tooth is illuminated with blue light in the wavelength range of 400 to 500 nanometer. Difference seen in the fluorescence of the sound enamel and caries enamel. When this fluorescent tooth is viewed through the specific broadband gelatin filter, white spot lesion appears darker than the enamel. If the white light source is connected to endoscope by the fiber optic cable, there is no need of the filter. This is called white light endoscopy. Additional camera can also be used to restore the image, and the integration of the camera with endoscope is known as videoscope. Advantage of this method is provides the magnified image and also clinically feasible. This advantage is requires the meticulous drying and isolation of teeth. It is time consuming and very costly and cannot be used in inaccessible area. Next, caries detector dyes. Caries detector dyes used to provide the visual of location of caries dentin. Caries detection dyes are applied directly to the teeth being treated. Healthy tissue is unaffected while infected dentin takes on the color of dyes. These materials are used to help you distinguish between the affected and infected dentin. Dyes selectively complex with the caries tooth structure, which is later disclosed with the help of fluorescence. It aids in the both quantitative and qualitative analysis of lesion. There are two types of the dyes: dyes used for the enamel caries and dyes used for the dentinal caries. There are many disadvantages of the dyes. Dye staining and bacterial penetration are independent phenomena, hence no actual quantification. Dyes also stains the food debris, enamel pellicle and other organic matter. It also stains the dentino-enamel junction. Today, we learned about visual and tactile methods of diagnosis. In next video, I will explain radiographic methods of diagnosis. I am Dr. Bindu. For more videos, subscribe my channel. Seeing you in next video. Bye for now.